Welcome to the California Department of Education Integrated and Designated English Language Development Transitional Kindergarten through Grade 12 video series. Designated English Language Development, Building Into and From Science in Grades 11 and 12. In this lesson, the students are reviewing and practicing listening, speaking, and writing skills to exchange information and ideas that build the language resources necessary to articulate and present their ideas about human impact on the environment. The students will use these language resources to accurately demonstrate their understanding of the science content in speaking and writing, now and when they return to their science class. The focal California English Language Development Standards guiding this lesson. The English Language Development Standards at the bridging level are Grades 11 and 12, Part 1, Standard 5, Listening Actively, where students demonstrate comprehension of oral presentations and discussions on a variety of social and academic topics by asking and answering detailed and complex questions that show thoughtful consideration of the ideas or arguments with light support. Grades 11 and 12, Part 1, Standard 9, Presenting, where students plan and deliver a variety of oral presentations and reports on grade-appropriate topics that express complex and abstract ideas, well supported by evidence and reasoning, and are delivered by using an appropriate level of formality and understanding of register. And grades 11 and 12, Part 2, Standard 1, Understanding Text Structure, where students apply analysis of the organizational structure of different text types to comprehending texts and to writing clear and cohesive arguments, informative and explanatory texts, and narratives. Watch how students move from early levels of proficiency toward the bridging levels of these English language development standards throughout the lesson. The supporting California Next Generation Science Standards used in tandem with the focal English language development standards. The science performance expectation is high school, life sciences 2, subitem 7, ecosystems, interactions, energy, and dynamics, where students who demonstrate understanding design, evaluate, and refine a solution for reducing the impacts of human activities on the environment and biodiversity. Watch for how these California standards are addressed throughout the lesson. Watch how the teacher leads the students to review their written explanations, use peers as resources to expand upon their ideas, articulate solutions, and develop language structures and vocabulary. The students engage in small group discussions that require active listening and oral rehearsal to cultivate the use of a more academic register by exchanging ideas and clarifying information as they solidify their content understanding.
Today, what we're doing is we're just continuing working with the problem solution text and kind of gaining confidence, interacting with reading and summarizing and paraphrasing and questioning, coming up with additional solutions and hopefully preparing us for our biology presentations that we'll be doing later today. Activity 3 is the group discussion where you get to tell another group about your problem, a solution, and you guys have a dialogue and talk about your problems, right? Solutions and you're building and helping each other out. So here's what it'll look like. Just make sure you're standing with your partner, right? Just like that, okay? And so what we'll model is if, for example, if this is pizza and this is attendance, right? So let's just say it's pizza and attendance talking to each other. Pizza will go first, for example, and pizza will share for, does anyone remember how many minutes?
5 minutes,
right? We're looking for 5 minutes, but since there's two of you, it kind of breaks it down to how much?
2.5.
2.5, so a little bit of English and math for you, okay? So about 2.5 minutes, that's what we're looking for, extended speaking time. And so as they are speaking, what is this group doing?
Listening,
okay? So behind us, we've got the four L's of active listening, just making sure, I know you guys have heard this so many times being here at Mission Hills, is looking at your partner, you're leaning in, but not too much, All right? You're lowering your voice so that everyone can hear and participate, and then you're listening closely because what could potentially be asked of you?
Questions.
Bingo, say it again.
Questions.
Questions, right? And so if we're not listening, we might not be able to answer the
questions.
Okay, thanks, Iris. All right, and then after, I don't know, a few minutes, I got you on time. I'll read the room. I'll ask you to rotate again. Okay?
The main problem of this paragraph was that the Dr. Miller is against, because tigers are getting, they're vanishing, and then they're trying to make like this, they're trying to donate to save these tigers.
Well, these tigers are disappearing, and they're disappearing really fast, so what this Dr. Miller wants to do is to tigers that are extinct. So his solution to this problem is to write to their Congress people and, like he said, donate to save the tigers. But our additional solution is to people to be responsible for their actions, because you know how people hunt these tigers and do not realize the consequence of their actions. And also, I think pollution gets into here, because if you throw the trash, then some animals get trapped and die, and they can go. This can go really badly because the food web can get hurt.
Mm-hmm. And then these donations will help to support the empower for those people who are fighting against the vanishing of the tigers.
Questions? So your problem is that many tigers are like getting extinct. And your solution is like prevent them, protect them?
Yeah.
From the people that are damaged them?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Another question is, do you know what specific tiger is that?
No.
No.
Like?
No? The, I don't know how to call it, the one is orange with white.
Yeah, basically.
And the white one, Bengali.
Almost there, keep it going, good job.
I think, parents have to pay more attention for their kids to follow their kids' attendance, academic of the school. And if you are really sick to come to school, it's fine, but don't miss a lot of day for the school, and that's not good. And they can miss their lesson and can follow their partner, their classmate, and can get a good grade.
Yeah, but sometimes the kids don't like to come to school. They prefer to stay at home.
Actually, I think it is a good solution. I call the attendance for grades, because the students could be more responsible for the.
So what you're saying is that show attendance will be a little bit later?
Well, I call for the grades.
Okay.
Could be a compliment.
So like, if you're absent, your grade will lower.
Yeah. I mean, a percentage, like attendance could be account 30% of.
So attendance would be like if you were, like if it was a grade, right?
Yeah.
A grade for a
class. People have different educations.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I don't know. Actually, for me, it's a solution for that.
It will be great, I think. Nobody will be absent, I think. Well, there will be absent.
If you justify your absence,
45 seconds, okay.
No, awesome.
When a river receives a lot of water and flow, there is plenty of water, then many people don't care about it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's risk, and many people can get disease and they can get sick.
Yeah, we are talking about flooding, and you know about it. It's so dangerous. and our solution is we have to repair the fresh water for drinking and repair the food when the food is coming. And besides, you can use the sandbag to protect your house so that the water not coming to your house. So our question is, what should we do when the food is coming? What the best choice when the food is coming, and how we face to fight with this?
I think we have to put all the important documents in that bag to protect everything important.
I mean, the best choice is we should use the.
Can you clarify the car, like where the problem was?
The problem?
Yeah, what's the problem? Because I didn't.
The problem is when the food is coming, the water will rise to your house, and the flooding water we cannot drink it, yes. And if you drink it, it's not good for your health, and the flooding of the water also rise for the roar, and the car can ride on this. And I mean, when you make the big flooding, then many people lost there. I mean, someone can die.
So we can have other water bottles. Yeah, like a part.
Yeah.
Or do you need to create something that makes the water dirty into water, like clean water?
So here's something I was thinking, just kind of watching you guys, and normally this is how we structure things, right? It's like individual time, it's small group time, it's whole group time. We're up doing rotations. Where's Cynthia at, right? You love rotations. Okay, well, we're up and we're doing these little small little lessons. What would be the purpose of you guys rotating, standing up, rotating, talking to other people? What's the purpose of that? Just kind of off the top of your head. Yeah, what's that?
Practicing the language and practicing and making like the purpose of what we're doing,
mm-hmm.
and explaining our ideas to others.
Yeah. And it's really cool too, because I like when you said practicing the language. Maybe instead of just memorizing word, you're using it.
And using your own words.
And using your own words, which is nice. Yeah, Jose.
So getting opinion from different people, and also getting out the fear of talking from like other people.
That's a huge one, yeah. Right? Yeah, talking in front of people.
Yeah.
And then hearing other perspectives, right? Which is really good.
What I learned was how to know or identify the central idea of the other person and listen closely to my peers. And what I do, well, I would do better to prepare and participate in class discussion will be find more evidence to support my claim and use it, explain it how.
I think that this will help us to another classes, like for example biology, like we have that
presentation
we have to do, so we can start our sentence or our how do you say the presentation with some examples that we learn here.
And I think this will help us in biology the same, because. The presentations we're gonna do,
they're like similar,
but
biology, and
it will help us to connect and react, how to react when we're in groups.
And so another solution that I aspire is how to have a better discussion between my peers and how to address them better.
Actually, you have ideas from solve the solutions, but you call solve the solutions just is like your idea for solve that. So actually, something that I care that I have is like how to interacting with people and trying to solve a problem and share ideas and discussing about that topic.
Something that I can do better to prepare and participate in class discussion will be come up with more ideas, questions to become an expert on the topic, to can share to my partners, like interact with them about the team.
Yeah, and I think that sentence frames help us to communicate and introduce ourselves to have a better academic conversation. So that's the why sentence frames are important to know and use them to develop our English.
Beyond the designated English language development lesson, building into and from content instruction. By engaging in designated English language development lessons such as this one, with opportunities for oral rehearsal, students are better prepared to engage with grade-level science content and are more confident to use an expanded range of language resources to explain their understanding. In addition, having students intentionally reflect on why engaging in collaborative speaking and listening activities such as this one will help them in other core classes affords them the opportunity to recognize interdisciplinary connections and successfully access content with increasing independence.
Do you know why recycling wasn't brought up in the past?
Because back in the past there was not a lot of trash on, like, in the streets, so they now have the necessity to do it.
Why do you think there wasn't a lot of pollution in the past?
Because back in the days there was like more natural resources like plants and everything. Doesn't exist the plastic.
And maybe also like before we didn't really like notice all these effects, but like now since there's more and more piling up, we're like looking at the effects now. Yeah.
Reflection and discussion. Reflect on the following questions. First, how did you observe the following focal English language development standards and supporting content standards being implemented in this grade 11 and 12 designated English language development lesson? English language development, part 1, standard 5, listen actively. Part 1, standard 9, presenting. Part 2, standard 1, understanding text structure. And life sciences 2, sub-item 7, ecosystems, interactions, energy, and dynamics. Second, what features of designated English language development did you observe in the lesson? Now pause the video and engage in a discussion with colleagues. The California Department of Education would like to thank the administrators, teachers, and students who participated in the making of this video. This video was made possible by the California Department of Education, in collaboration with WestEd and Tambor Films.